Stoicism: How to Use Stoic Philosophy to Find Inner Peace and Happiness. Written by Jason Hemlock. Narrated by Fred Filbrick. Introduction. It's time you realized that you have something in you more powerful and miraculous than the things that affect you and make you dance like a puppet. Marcus Aurelius. In an uncertain world, many of us are searching for something that will help us, if not make sense of it all, then at least be able to cope with the fast pace of change. Although our very modern lifestyle would be unfathomable to our ancestors, it's widely recognized that the ancient Greeks and Romans had figured out the answers to many universal issues we still deal with today. After all, although they might not be able to comprehend a world of iPhones and electric cars, problems such as relationship breakups, job loss, financial difficulties, etc., were just as prevalent then as they are now. If you're looking to realize your potential and make the most of your experiences, there's a lot to be learned from ancient philosophers, who dedicated themselves to the question of what constitutes a good life and how you can make the most of your opportunities. There's a good reason why the ancient philosophies have stood the test of time and persist to exert an influence over us thousands of years later. Stoicism is a type of Hellenistic philosophy that enjoyed a resurgence 20 or so years ago. It offers up a code of conduct and ethics, which empowers its adherents to live a good life. While Stoicism places an emphasis on self-discipline and improvement, an inevitable side effect of that process is that it empowers you to achieve your potential, enabling you to live your best life. It is for that reason that Stoicism has proven popular among countless leaders, successful business people and entrepreneurs, as well as famous musicians, artists, and actors. It offers not just a roadmap to happiness, but guidance on how to achieve your goals, stay calm in challenging times, and be your best possible, most authentic self. You can sum up Stoicism with one simple idea. You need to accept full control of and take total responsibility for your thoughts and actions. When you do this, you step onto the path of personal fulfillment. Regardless of your social status, health, or abilities, Stoicism will support you to become more than you ever dreamed possible, which is why it's proven to be so popular with successful entrepreneurs and leaders in their field. However, as you'll discover when you follow a Stoic philosophy, Stoicism has a far greater potential than just self-help, as if that wasn't motivation enough to practice it. When you take on a Stoic approach, you'll discover it has the potential to change the world around you permanently and for the good of all. A brief overview of Stoicism. Stoicism was founded by Zeno of Cetium sometime in the early 3rd century BC. He taught philosophy at the Stoa Poikile, which is what gave the movement its name, meaning painted porch. The Stoa Poikile was a colonnade by the Agora in Athens. And in choosing the site, Zeno already demonstrated that what he was teaching was different to existing schools of thought, as most philosophers refused to teach in public places. Taking a logical approach to personal ethics, Stoicism teaches that happiness comes from accepting each moment as it comes, an attitude somewhat akin to modern mindfulness, which is currently very popular. Stoicism states that an individual shouldn't allow themselves to be driven by either fear or a thirst for pleasure, but instead should seek to understand the world in which we live, find and fulfill your place in nature, and work in harmony with others, dealing with them in a fair and just manner. Stoics held that external goals, such as health or wealth, are neither inherently good nor bad, but instead are there to act as a facilitation for virtue. This pursuit of virtue sometimes involved intentionally depriving yourself of the finer things in life, which is how this ancient philosophy came to give us the term Stoic. A Stoic, in the dictionary sense of the word, is someone who is able to endure difficulties without complaint, and this is just one of the many benefits of following this philosophy. As Epictetus says, "Don't seek for everything to happen as you wish it would, but rather wish that everything happens as it actually will. Then your life will flow well." This attitude means that Stoics are especially well-suited to cope with hardships and tough times, and are equipped with the mental fortitude to survive situations that might break another person. However, it would be a mistake to believe that a Stoic doesn't feel emotion or care about pain. The Stoics sought freedom from being ruled by their passions by using logic and reason. They weren't looking to eliminate their emotions so much as transcend them by developing clarity of thought and inner peace. They looked to achieve a high degree of self-control, self-awareness, and self-discipline. Stoicism was, and is, an eminently practical philosophy. It is not enough to say the right things. To the Stoics, the best demonstration of one's beliefs came from their behavior. If you follow the natural order of things, this includes bad as well as good times, and the ability to move with the flow of the tides is key to living a good life. If you are able to free your mind to think clearly and without bias, you will be able to understand the logos, or divine reason, flowing through the cosmos. In addition, you'll be able to rise above negative, petty emotions like anger or jealousy, giving you a healthier outlook on and experience of life. Stoicism was highly popular across the Roman and Greek empires until the 3rd century AD. The Emperor Marcus Aurelius was one of its most quoted proponents. His Meditations is still considered to be an important philosophical text even today, and is a book you should read if you're serious about your Stoic studies. A prolific writer, he wrote many other Stoic letters and works during his lifetime. But sadly, these have been lost in the mists of time. As Christianity grew to become the state religion of Rome in the 4th century AD, Stoicism's popularity waned. But it has seen many resurgences over the centuries, particularly during the Renaissance, and of course, in modern times. Famous Stoics. Following a Stoic approach to life has proven popular with highly successful people throughout the centuries. Many of the most famous names in history have turned to Stoicism to help them through their challenges, giving us very clear examples of how important Stoicism has been over the ages. If you are wondering what Stoicism could do for you, here's a small selection of some of the most famous Stoics throughout history to give you some inspiration. Epictetus started his life as a slave. With the permission of his owner, he studied philosophy under the Stoic Musonius Rufus, and after he was freed, set up his own school. While none of his writings have survived, one of his pupils, the famous philosopher Arrian, transcribed Epictetus' Discourses and Enchiridion. If evil be spoken of you and it be true, correct yourself. If it be a lie, laugh at it. Epictetus. Seneca was a philosopher, dramatist, and close advisor to Emperor Nero. Following a failed assassination plot, Nero ordered Seneca to commit suicide. Although Seneca was probably innocent, he was more concerned about comforting his loved ones than his own death. We should every night call ourselves to an account. What infirmity have I mastered today? What passions opposed? What temptation resisted? What virtue acquired? Our vices will abate of themselves if they be brought every day to the shrift. Seneca. Marcus Aurelius was the last of the 5 good emperors and ruled over the Roman Empire from 161 to 180. His Meditations is a series of personal notes and letters written to help him reflect on compassion, restraint, and self-humility. While it isn't likely they were ever meant to be published, Meditations has become one of the most influential Stoic texts. Time is a sort of river of passing events, and strong is its current. No sooner is a thing brought to sight than it is swept by, and another takes its place, and this too will be swept away. Marcus Aurelius. Why you should be a Stoic. So now you've had a brief overview of Stoicism and seen just how many high achievers follow a Stoic philosophy. It should be obvious that Stoicism delivers results, not just in terms of unlocking your potential, but in helping you achieve that also-elusive state of contentment. But if you still needed a little more convincing to get involved yourself, here are a few more good reasons. Stoicism gives you resilience in difficult times. Stoicism arose during a period when the world was in chaos. Just a few brief decades before, Alexander the Great had conquered the world, then died in his early 30s. His passing had a devastating effect on his empire, plunging it into uncertainty. Stoicism had a natural appeal during these troubled years because it gave followers a sense of security and offered a solid foundation during a time of conflict. Unlike religion, It didn't make any promises of a tranquil life after death, but instead focused on giving.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.